Let me see. I done repositioned everybody, Jesus. Hold on, let me see. Okay, I got everybody repositioned. I'm sorry. Hey. I done moved the cameras. I don't move the camera, so I got everybody positioned wrong. I guess this is probably good. Y'all can see, right? Good. It's gonna work, okay? If you can't use your imagination. Running away with me. Hey! Happy Friday! Happy Friday, everybody. Let's do it, huh? Let's do it. Let's do it. Making sure y'all can see me. Everybody can see. All right. What we gonna do? You know ain't nothing ready, right? You know ain't nothing ready, right? Let's do this. I got a few strawberries on their way out. I just got a few strawberries. They're on their way out. Happy Good Friday, everybody. Hopefully y'all are safe at home and quarantining. Happy Good Friday or Passover or whatever you celebrate, okay? I just got a few strawberries that's on their way out the door. So let's figure out how we could use them really quickly. Make sure you hit the share button. Oh, let me cut the oven on. Okay, let me preheat the oven. Hold on. I'm gonna put it on convection, 400 degrees convection. Ooh, these strawberries done seen better days. I think one more day in the refrigerator and it would have been over for these strawberries. Which means that they're probably gonna be extra sweet by the time we get ready to really hook them up. Okay, throw you a couple of strawberries in. I'm gonna put a little water in here and I'm gonna sweeten this with a little sugar. All right, let's blend this together. Strawberries, this can be frozen too, by the way. This does not have to be strawberries that are fresh. I'm just using them because that's what I got, okay? That quick. Strawberry puree. Hold on, y'all. Strawberry puree. We're gonna throw some of this in a little container. This, I like to store my stuff in like a little plastic container. Let's make a cocktail, why don't we? They say the camera, oh, let's make sure the cameras are good. Let's make sure the cameras are good. They look all right. They look all right, huh? Okay. Ice. Wipe us down. on Periscope. Y'all not clean. They said Periscope. We're not in focus. How y'all not in focus? It's kind of fuzzy. If it's fuzzy on Instagram, you know it's Instagram. It's not me. If it's fuzzy on Instagram, you know it's Instagram. It's not me. You know how Instagram is. Go watch on YouTube, Periscope, or Facebook. Okay? You know how Instagram is. Okay? If it's fuzzy, you know Instagram be doing their own thing. So it's not the device. It's literally, that's how Instagram is. All right? Can't do anything about that. I'm sorry. All I can do is control what I can control. And I can't control Instagram. I don't have the keys. Let me get some ice. All right, once you get your ice, let's build, all right? Yeah, it's Instagram. That strawberry syrup that we just made, let's pour some of that in that cocktail shaker. Right, because we could do that, okay, maybe a little more, okay. Then I've got some lemon sour cocktail mixer. Don't worry if you can't find lemon sour, just use lemon juice and simple syrup, okay. Simple syrup is equal parts water and sugar with lemon juice, okay. Done, all right, simple, all right, not even that serious. I'm gonna drop in a touch of Curacao, which is, this is a, like an orange liqueur, just a touch to round it out. And then some Añejo rum, like a golden rum, Don Julio, Bacardi, whatever you like, okay? Whatever you like. A couple of shots of rum. They said Facebook is horrible tonight. Let me see if I can wipe the camera down. You know I don't control this stuff, y'all. They said it's blurry on Facebook. Facebook, you know I don't control it. I'm wiping the camera, so I don't think it's the camera. It might just be the way Facebook is. You see what I'm saying? If you want Facebook, hold on 1 second. I could get off the Wi-Fi, okay? If you want, not this Facebook, y'all fine. My Facebook friends, you guys are fine. But my Facebook fan page, you say it's blurry. And, they say Facebook line, it's as clear as day. Now, which one is it? Is Facebook good or no? Cause y'all, first y'all say it's not clear, then y'all say it is clear on Facebook. So I don't really know what to do. All right, I'm not gonna worry about it. That's what I'm not gonna do. I'm not gonna worry about it. Give that a shake. Strawberry lemonade daiquiris, okay? All right. Strawberry lemonade daiquiris we just made, okay? All right. Nice and cold. Give it a good shake. Good shake. Get a glass. All right. Get a glass and go and give you a pour, okay? That's cold. Hold on. Come on, pour. You know we got those strawberries in there. Come on, hold on. Come on. How you do that. Strawberry lemonade daiquiris. fresh strawberry syrup. You know how it tastes already. Delicious. Fridays are for fish fries. I would sing the keto song, but ain't nothing about tonight keto. So if you a visitor, welcome. Have a seat, okay? Listen, if you need a copy of any of the cookbooks, we have them, okay? And I'm running a little mini sale right now because we're cooking out of the cookbooks next week. Next week? Week after next? Soon. You can grab the cookbooks, shopdariuscooks.com. Use the code Corona. Now, little birdie told me if you use the code Corona20, you can get a book for $20. Okay? A little birdie told me just until this broadcast is over, if you use the code Corona20, you can get a cookbook for $20. Huh? Y'all hungry? Me too. Oh, you know ain't nothing ready. I don't even want to hear your mouth. I don't even want to hear your mouth. Ain't nothing ready today, okay? Everything ain't gonna take time. Y'all ain't got no place to go nowhere. Let me get a knife. I got a... Grab you an onion. And we're gonna slice them up. Whatever kind you got. This is a nice yellow onion. It don't have to be yellow. It could be red. Hey, y'all. I'm so happy to see y'all. You have no idea, okay, how happy I am that all of you guys are here and present. I didn't go live yesterday because I'm like, I need a break. It seemed like everybody is live. And everybody be trying to cook live, don't they? I say God bless their heart. I'm gonna let the people shine. You see what I'm saying? I'm gonna let the people shine, and I said, you know what? I said, you know, give me a day, I'll come back on tomorrow, something like that, you know. Plus, I be needing my alone time by myself, you know. I'm fine quarantining alone. I've been watching, where am I? Oh, season 2 of The Cosby Show. If you have Amazon Prime, The Cosby Show is on, and it is hilarious, okay? Like, it is literally hilarious. I be falling out. Season 2 is when Russell, Cliff's father, came over and they were playing Pinochle. And remember when Cliff and Claire were going out for dinner and Claire was buying dinner and they had a contest and the kids judged to see who could be the flyest. And Claire had on, she had broke her toe. It's so good. It brings back so many memories. That and Mrs. Westlake. Mrs. Westlake. Okay? So many memories. I looked up today, because you know, you don't realize the amount of history in the Cosby Show. You know what I mean? And so I looked up today, the guy that played Cliff's professor when he was in college, and he died when he was like in his 80s, which wasn't too long after he had recorded the show. But he had been like this black actor who had done like Broadway and movies, and he would, I forgot his name, Lee something, but he would only do roles that show him in a positive light, you know? He didn't do roles that show him, that show blacks in like a negative light. So it's just nice, you know, to be able to look back at, for what it's worth, you know, the Cosby Show, and just be so inspired by like the stuff that was going on. I just think it's great. Okay, onion and garlic into a skillet with some olive oil. And then look, I got some, this is chicken Italian sausage. It smells amazing. This doesn't have to be chicken. You could do regular, you know, but this is at my farmer's market. They had it, I'm fancy, whatever. So I'm gonna throw in my chicken Italian sausage right in here. So this cooks up with the onion and the garlic. And you know, you gotta break it up. You know, when you put it in, you know, you gotta break it up, because if you don't break it up, it'll clump up on you, and that's no good. You know that, right? We'll let that cook. Meanwhile, let's get the rest of our ingredients. Yes, I'm using a jarred pasta sauce. Okay? Whoa! Yes! I'm using a jarred pasta sauce. I know that is like literally almost unheard of for me, but I'm using it. I know. I kind of feel like you're going through so much work. Shut up, okay? Shut up, all right? I feel like you're going through so much other work, like doing this recipe, that I kind of feel like at the end of the day, it's okay for the jarred pasta sauce. Chop frozen spinach, okay? Chop frozen spinach. If you use the fresh, you have to cook it down, drain it, and you know how spinach is. You have to get a lot of spinach in to do it. So I'm not doing that. Okay, into the pot. Let's season it somewhat. I'm growing fresh oregano. I'm growing a lot of stuff, okay? But I'm growing fresh oregano. If you're on my Instagram, which everybody should be following me on Instagram, because I went live on Instagram today and I did a quick little tour of like my garden and my greenhouse, and I showed how I have a bounty of oregano. So I'm just gonna pull, and this is fresh oregano, I'm just gonna pull off the leaves off of the fresh oregano. Look at that. This is how fresh oregano, isn't that great? Isn't that fantastic? Fresh oregano. If you get some of the small leaves, it's fine. I mean, the small stems, it's okay. Because the stems have flavor too. The other day we did, what did we do? We did this with, We did this with, garlic and lemon, and then grilled up some pork chops. Boy, was that good. Little chop of fresh oregano. We're gonna throw this right in with the sausage and the onion and all that stuff going on in there. All right, and I'm already starting to feel that the daiquiri. Strawberry lemonade. Make sure as it cooks, you break it up. I just can't make a pasta sauce without a little red wine. So, a little scotch of red wine. And then we're gonna take this jar, your favorite jarred pasta sauce, okay? I know, normally I make my own, but today I'm not, okay? Your favorite jarred pasta sauce. And we're gonna throw it right in, all right? This is a low sugar pasta sauce, okay? But how bad could this be? Okay, so this is that chicken sausage, the red wine, the garlic, the onion, and that fresh oregano, okay? And I didn't cook the chicken sausage all the way, all right? So don't be trying to eat this, okay? All right. Y'all praying? Okay. Into a bowl, ricotta cheese. Cheese in there. And then I want you to grab whatever you got, half and half, heavy cream, it doesn't matter. Add a little bit of that to the situation. Fresh cracked black pepper. I think you know where we're going with this. Okay? Pinch of salt. Let me grab some Italian seasoning and some garlic powder. Garlic powder and Herbes de Provence will work. It's ricotta cheese, but I kind of want to just jazz up the ricotta cheese a little bit, you know? Okay, Herbes de Provence, garlic powder. Simple stuff, right? Just go and throw that together and break up that ricotta cheese mixture. with that heavy cream. All right, then let's put this together, okay? This is a very simple little skillet lasagna, okay? Very simple little skillet lasagna. Listen, they sell these oven-ready pasta noodle sheet thingies. Okay, they sell these already, ready to go. This is, okay, oven ready. Let's build it. Y'all ready? I got a skillet. I'll put some of the sauce. And this is why I didn't really cook that chicken all the way through. Because I really wanted to use some of that on the bottom, and I'm gonna put it in the oven. See that? Real simple, right? Now, you gotta break these up, okay? Hold on, I think I'm sweating. I might be a little warm. Let me cut my air conditioner on. Hold on one second. Let me cut on my air. Okay. It's a little warm in Jerusalem, Doc. Okay. I'm just keeping it real, okay? Keeping it real with Nene. Y'all remember that? Okay, come on. Oven ready lasagna pasta sheet situations, okay? We're gonna break them up so that they fit. This don't have to be perfect, please, okay? This don't have to be perfect. This could be just real nice and rustic, okay? We're going for some rusticity here, okay? So we're gonna put a little more, just a little sculpture sauce right there. And then we're gonna take the spinach and throw that right through here. Okay, this is very rustic. This is not like fancy at all, okay? This is like super, like oh, this is rustic. This is nice, okay? Then we're gonna dot, this is that herbed ricotta cheese mixture. Just like throw that around here, right? Just throw it around. Like just dot it, throw it, you know, add as much as you like. And this is also why I didn't cook that, make the sauce from scratch. Cause I'm like, why make it from scratch when it don't really matter? You know what I mean? Okay, put a little sauce here, a little of your pasta sauce. All right, let's do another layer. Okay. Now I'm just pressing it down in there too. And then break it so that it can fit sort of all over. See that? And you can double up with the pasta because it'll cook through amazingly well. Okay. And that's it. Let's just do some sauce on top, and then we're gonna add some cheese on top of this, because we can do that. We can do that, can we not? Now, if you wanna make your sauce from scratch, by all means, let the force be with you. Go for it, okay? I'm not doing it. But you can, okay? Let me get rid of this. Let me get rid of this and this. Listen, by the way, if you need a copy of any of the cookbooks, okay? We're gonna be cooking from them next week. If you need a copy of them, go to shopdariuscooks.com. Use the code CORONA20 until this broadcast is over, and you can get the books for only $20. Okay? CORONA20. Now, if you happen to watch this broadcast and it's not live, use the code CORONA and you can save 20%. Okay? Fontina. Thin slices of Fontina cheese. This could be whatever you like, okay? This does not have to be Fontina. This could be a lovely, you know what's good in this? A smoked Gouda. I don't know about it. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. A smoked Gouda would be great. I got some mozzarella too, huh? Okay, please be sure to put this on a sheet tray, because this will bubble over. And the last thing you want is for this to bubble over while it's in your oven and make a mess. Our first responders are busy with the COVID pandemic. We don't need them trying to come to your house to save you, because you decide. Because you decided to make a skillet lasagna and not cover it up properly, okay? All right, mozzarella cheese. This don't have to be mozzarella, okay? This could be cheddar. This could be white cheddar. You know what's real good? If you shred some of that, what's that white cheddar in the green block? The little green Cracker Barrel. I don't know who Cracker is. I don't know who Barrel is. I don't know where them cows come from. I don't know. But it's something about that Cracker Barrel. First of all, it's expensive, okay? It's all get out. All right, it ain't cheap. But I gotta tell you something. That thing is amazing. Okay? That thing is literally amazing. Take your little Italian seasoning and sprinkle it on top like you're doing something. Sprinkle you a little Italian season like you do. Y'all see that? Sprinkle it like you're doing something. Huh? Okay, come on. This got to go in the oven. 400 degrees. Yes. That's our skillet lasagna, y'all, with the chicken sausage. If you like it spicy, spice yours up. If you like it spicy, spice yours up. Ain't nobody stopping you. You see what I'm saying? Spicy. Strawberry lemonade. daiquiri. Cheers! Okay. I want you to grab you some mayonnaise. Whatever kind you like, it don't really matter. Okay? This is the Hellman's, because that's what they had on sale. Okay? This is the Hellman's, because this is what they had on sale. They had the Hellman's on sale. Put your little mayonnaise in here, okay? All right. Then, I want you to grab you, you know, let me use this. I would say grab some sour cream. You know, you got a cough in your elbow. But I have a little Mexican crema in the refrigerator. So I'm gonna use that. Okay, in there. I'm gonna use a little Mexican. This could be sour cream though. All right. Can we season this, please? With a little salt. That's a little salt. I read y'all comments. Y'all be like, that's so much salt. It wasn't that much salt. Fresh cracked black pepper. Okay. Some of that garlic powder. Can we put a little pinch of that in there, please? And then let's do a little pinch of onion powder while we at it. That's it. We cooking now, baby. I need you to add a little pinch of sugar to this. I don't want to hear your mouth, okay? I do not want to hear your mouth. You need a little sugar in this. If you're doing strictly keto, make that monk fruit sweetener, okay? I want you to take the good tequila, okay? Your good tequila. And put you a scotch of your good tequila in there. That's one of the reasons you need the sugar. Tequila is a little bitter, okay? It's a little bitter. And you need that sugar to help balance out that bitterness, okay? Then I want you to take the juice, about 2 limes. Depends on how juicy they are. You know, sometimes the limes be real juicy, and sometimes they don't be that juicy at all, okay? And I want you to squeeze in your juice. Can y'all see? Squeeze in your juice and your lime. Look, this lime ain't got no juice in it. This is a stingy one. It ain't got but a little bit. See what I'm saying? It's a little juice. I use a fork. See how easy it is with a fork? You basically just turn the fork one way and you twist the other way. Whisk this together, would you? Let me see if we need a little more salt and pepper. Hold on. it's a little coleslaw dressing. A little tequila lime coleslaw for the fish fry. Cause you gotta have a little, you gotta have a little piece of coleslaw to go with your fish fry. Yes, it's Friday. Good Friday at that. Okay? They hung him high. They stretched him wide. How I go? Hold on. They hung him high. They stretched him wide. The, something, he hung his head. For me, he died, that's love. That's love. Oh my God. Why it tastes like that? Okay? That's why you need, oh my God. Y'all, oh my God, that is. What I'm gonna do is, so I don't dirty up no more bowls. I'm gonna put this right in here. Okay, tequila lime coleslaw dressing. Okay. Now we're gonna use this same bowl to make our coleslaw. Okay, we'll use the same bowl to make our coleslaw in 1 second. But that's it, okay? Very simple, tequila lime coleslaw. We got to fry some fish. Y'all all right? I feel fantastic. Strawberry lemonade daiquiris with a fresh strawberry syrup. Cast iron skillet, because my grandmother would have it no other way. Okay. Cast iron skillet. Get your cast iron skillet hot, okay? And then I want you to use whatever you got, okay? Peanut, canola, vegetable, corn, Crisco. I don't care. Just use you something, okay? All right. Ooh, baby. Let's go. Let's do it. Okay. Catfish fillets. This don't have to be catfish. You want to smell it. You know what it should smell like? Nothing. That's how you know it's fresh, okay? It should smell like nothing, okay? Before I rinse this off, I got fillets. I'm gonna cut my fillets in half on a bias, okay? I'm gonna cut my fillet. Don't ask me why. Because sometimes the big fillets, they be too big. So I'm gonna cut it in half on the bias. Okay? Like, this is way big. So I can get 3 pieces out of this. Okay? 3 pieces. There was a restaurant one time called Soul Crab. You might have heard about it. Some of the best catfish you ever had in your life. Some of the best fried catfish you ever had in your life. I'm gonna show you how we made it. Rinse your catfish off real good. Oh, by the way, let me get that oil hot. Let me get that oil hot. Hold on. I'm going about a half an inch in the cast iron skillet. If you want to deep fry, that's fine too. I'm going to do a little shallow fry, okay? I'm going to do a little shallow fry. The key ingredient, buttermilk. Don't do this without buttermilk, okay? Key ingredient, thick, luscious buttermilk. Take my word for it. Okay? All right, let's season this up. You're going to believe how simple this is. You're not going to believe how simple this is. Old Bay. You know, it's very little salt in Old Bay. So everything I'm putting in is very little salt. A little cayenne. Ground fennel. Hold on, let me put some more. let me find some more fennel. Hold on. It wasn't really much in there, huh? Hold the line, please. Hold the line. I got some right here. Hold on. You ought to see my spice cabinet. I got everything. Okay, a little ground fennel. Little garlic powder, actually all of that. Little onion powder. Some salt. And this is what we call our house seasoning. Simple. Let me get a glove. I don't know what it, oh, I see them. I'm like, where the gloves at? Here they go. Now that buttermilk does a couple of things. That buttermilk helps that seasoning really stick to this and adhere to it, okay? And it helps evenly distribute all. How could that be bad? How could this be bad? There's nothing wrong with this whatsoever. Okay? Nothing wrong with this whatsoever. All right, now I'm gonna fry this catfish in a combo of flour and cornstarch. You don't have to do that. Okay? You don't have to do that. You can put yours in cornmeal. Now, I know we got a lot of people on here that are not African American, okay? You need to understand there is a rule, okay? And the rule is this. If you cook something in fish, you cook the grease, the fish in grease, this now becomes fish grease. You can cook nothing else, okay? You can cook nothing else in this oil but fish. Salmon croquette, fried anything, okay? Fried, whatever you wanna fry, you can fry it as long as it is fish grease. It is only for fish, okay? If you were doing this and this was chicken, then you can use the chicken grease. The chicken grease can be used for anything. Chicken, pork chops, cube steak, liver and onions, although I never ate that, okay? Listen, I might be as influenced by the country as I wanna be, but I never ate, I don't eat that, okay? Living onions, I'm good on that, Doc. You can have that, okay? No living and onions for me. Depends on who you are. Fried gizzards can be done in your chicken grease. That's fine, too. I don't eat that. I don't eat that. I never ate fried gizzards, okay? My grandmother loved a gizzard. Me, not so much. Okay, me, not so much, okay? What am I doing? Double dipping. This is the only time that's allowed, okay? I'm double dipping into that flavor. You see all this? This is flavor. I'm double dipping. So I'm coating it once and then I'm recoating it twice. So you dip it in the flour mixture first and then you dip it back into that lovely mixture of the spices with the buttermilk. Oh, that's hot, Doc. Come on. This stove is powerful. Hold on one second. Let's fry this up. Okay. All right. That's already frying. If you're just joining us, may I welcome you to our live stream. We're having a fantastic time. Do you mind if I refresh my drink? I need some ice. Hold on one second, please. Of course you don't mind. Of course you don't mind. Fresh strawberry syrup. You know, the one thing I think I forgot to put in last time is I have some strawberry syrup right here too for like an extra strawberry kick. All right, a little strawberry like cocktail mix. a little sweet and sour. No, you know what this is? This is the lemon sour. You could get the same effect by making lemon juice and simple syrup. Okay? And then a couple of shots of good rum. Golden rum. Flipping my fish. Flipping my fish. Give it a shake. Strawberry lemonade daiquiri. If you need a copy of any cookbook, okay? Let me move this over, hold on. It just, it, this burner is so hot. It gets so hot, I just get so nervous. If you need a copy of any cookbook, Stories from My Grandmother's Kitchen, Vegan But With Soul, or Everyday Keto. Everyday Keto, Vegan But With Soul, Stories from My Grandmother's Kitchen. Use the code CORONA20. $20 a piece. Only until this broadcast is over. If you're watching this broadcast after we're done going live, use the code CORONA. All right, remember that, hold the press. Did somebody say skillet lasagna? Listen, Instagram, they only give me an hour. You got a minute and 11 seconds. I'm gonna restart you, okay? Hold on. Let me restart Instagram, hold on. Instagram, they only give me an hour. I gotta restart y'all, hold on. How that look? Huh? That's why you need to put it on a sheet tray. You're gonna burn your house down with all this cheese. Huh? I'm gonna bring it close up to the camera. Hold on. This is Instagram and Periscope and Facebook and my other Facebook, and that's YouTube. Huh? Huh? Listen. Hold on. Let me grab my fish before it burns. It don't take your fish that long to cook. Now, back in the day, you used to put it on newspaper to drain it. But this newspaper today give you toe cancer and gangrene. So get you some paper towel. Isn't that beautiful? I mean, isn't that just beautiful? Have you ever seen something more? Isn't that just the most perfect piece of fish you've ever seen in your entire life? Okay. All right. Now I got a cabbage that has seen better days. I got a cabbage that has seen better days. I'm gonna cut off the parts of the cabbage I don't like. This is my cabbage from the other day, actually. This is my cabbage from the other day. I cooked cabbage live on here the other day. Look at that. Perfect. Okay, perfect. You know you don't waste no cabbage. Thin. I'm talking about fins. Can y'all see? I'm talking about thin slices. I'm talking about paper thin. So thin, it's only got one side. I'm talking about thin. Let me get this core out. Hold on. Shave it down real good and thin. That's enough. Look at that. I'm talking about shredded. You see that? Thin. If you got a food processor, throw it in the food processor. That's fine too. I don't feel like plugging mine up. Let me rinse this off, please. Hold the line. get you a few little pieces of paper towel. Okay, get you a few little pieces of paper towel. And I mean, get it dry. Now, personally, I like a little crunchy coleslaw myself, okay? If it's been sitting for a while, I'm gonna eat that one too. Hold on, that's a little wet, hold on. If it's been sitting for a while, I'm gonna eat that one too. Okay? Take your fresh cabbage. Okay, we just drying it off good. That's perfect. See how much water come out of that? Remember that bowl that we had? Look at that water. This is the bowl that we had that we made the dressing in. I'm gonna throw it in here. Now I'm gonna do something. My grandmother would do. I don't want to hear your mouth. I don't want to hear your mouth in the comments, okay? My grandmother would take a handful of raisins and throw it into the coleslaw. You don't have to do that. Okay, but I have these gorgeous yellow raisins. I mean golden yellow, golden juicy raisins, okay? You don't have to do this. You don't have to, but my grandmother used to, okay? And I'm telling you, it is delicious, okay? All right, I'm telling you, it is so good in your coast. You don't have to, but you're not eating this. Okay, if you don't like yours with raisins, don't put no raisins in there, okay? But I like mine homemade like this. That tequila lime, see, half the people say it's good, half the people say no, it's all right. Tequila lime, coleslaw dressing, okay? I don't want it too dressed, okay? I don't want it too dressed. This is tequila and lime. We made this with a little sour cream, in this case, Mexican crema, with some tequila and mayonnaise and fresh squeezed lime juice with a little garlic powder, a little onion powder, a little piece of sugar, okay? A little salt, a little pepper. Okay? Oh my God. Now the longer this sit, the better it tastes. I like mine a little crunchy though, okay? I like mine when it first come out like this. Mine don't have to be, mine don't have to sit, okay? I like mine like this here. And if you want, you can slice you some carrots in here. Let's go all the way down south, okay? You could grate you some carrots in here if you want to, or you could grate you some onion in here if you want to, okay? It's up to you, it's your coleslaw. It don't have to be that cold for me. I like mine like this, okay? I like it when it first come out like this. I like it when it's cold. It don't matter. And let me tell you something. Every once in a while, not all the time, every once in a while, my grandma would put a little piece of crushed pineapple in it. Every once in a while, a little piece of crushed pineapple. What I'm supposed to say, no? It's delicious. Thank you. every once in a while. Your mama too? Exactly. Y'all killing me, so I said, nah, I don't know. You know your grandma used to put a little piece of crushed pineapple, a pineapple tidbit or two, in your coleslaw every once in a while when she thought she was doing something. Okay? And you saying, well, all right, this ain't that bad. Don't act like that, okay? Do not act like that, okay? Let me see if I can show y'all this skillet lasagna. Hold on. See that? With the chicken sausage. We made that live. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh. Oh, oh, oh. And my dreams are very special. This that spinach chicken lasagna we just made. Y'all see that? Still smoking. You look straight into my eyes. Love and life. Fried catfish. Buttermilk. Buttermilk. Fried catfish. Okay? Buttermilk fried catfish. Tequila. Lime coleslaw. And this recipe, I'm sure, is in the Vegan But With Soul cookbook, because you can make this completely vegan. Okay, tequila, lime, coleslaw, along with a little scotch of strawberry lemonade daiquiri. Okay, take your favorite hot sauce. Throw it on there, like that. Take a look. Take a look. Catfish, coleslaw, it's light skin, you can't see it. And a little piece of lasagna. A little piece of catfish, a little piece of coleslaw. Y'all see that? Skillet lasagna, coleslaw, and catfish. Now listen, make sure you join our keto Facebook group. It's called Everyday Keto on Facebook. If you need a copy of any cookbook, either Stories from My Grandmother's Kitchen, Vegan But With Soul, and I bet the coleslaw is in this book. Hold on, let me see. Page 106 or 136. Let me see. 136. It ain't that one. 106. I'm shamed. I thought it was the, don't we got a Sloppy Joe recipe in here? Is it in here? Jackfruit. Let me see, hold on. 108, 118. Hold on, 108. I wrote the book, I just forgot. Okay, page 108. Now, I don't know if I did everything exactly like you say do it in here. Almost. I almost did everything right. Almost. Almost, okay? But anyway, it's on page 108 and 109. So if you need a copy of The Vegan But With Soul, Everyday Keto, or Stories from my grandmother's kitchen. You get these books by going to shopdariuscooks.com. Use the code CORONA20 until the end of this broadcast, $20 a piece, okay? After this, if you're watching the replay, the code is just CORONA. You'll save 20% until I get tired of it, okay? I'm gonna taste the coleslaw first. Oh, please, 1 second, bow your heads so we can say grace, please. Bow your heads so we can say grace. Grace. Okay, let's try the coleslaw first. Okay, this is that tequila lime coleslaw with the fresh cabbage that we made. See, here's the thing. Y'all talked about me because of the sugar I put in here. But the cabbage is bitter. Excuse me, it's bitter. And you need that sugar to balance everything out. Let me tell you something. Hands down, this is the best coleslaw ever. Fucking did that. Let me tell you something. Let's taste this lasagna. Look at this. This is that skillet lasagna. Okay. With the spinach and that creamy ricotta that we made. I want some. There's that spice in the background. Buttermilk fried catfish. Buttermilk fried golden juicy buttermilk fried What's that? You say? Crunch. What's that crunch from? Flour and cornstarch. don't forget, get a copy of any cookbook. ShopDariusCooks.com. Use the code Corona20. $20. I'm getting ready to disconnect the code. Okay? You got about 5 minutes to use that code. After that, use the code Corona. Recipes like this, you know where to find them. On my website, DariusCooks.tv. There's two things I want to tell you, as I always do. Food is my life. Life is my food. Until next time, I gotta wish you a happy cooking. From my heart to yours. Bye, y'all. It's so good.